والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. We continue with the scene of gathering and standing. We stopped before Isha when the human being, the race of Adam alayhi salam, are somehow transported from the burial area or the place where they are to the place of gathering. And we mentioned the nature of that. Some of them will be walking, some of them will be riding, and some of them will be on foot. Now, the condition is not really very pleasing, but I just want you to realize that these conditions are not going to be the same for each one. Of course, a disbeliever will experience different conditions. The sinners of the Muslims will experience different conditions. And also the believers will have different conditions. Like the believers will be comforted. They are not going to experience the anxiety and fear. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ سَبَقَتْ لَهُمْ مِنَّ الْحُسْنَى أُولَٰئِكَ عَنْهَا مُبْعَدُونَ لَا يَسْمَعُونَ حَسِيسَهَا وَهُمْ فِي مَا اشْتَهَتْ أَنفُسُهُمْ خَالِدُونَ. Look at this. لَا يَحْزُنُهُمُ الْفَزَعُ الْأَكْبَرُ. Indeed, those who receive the husna in this world, they will be saved from all of this. رب العالمين الله سبحانه وتعالى says في الحديث الإلهي وعزتي وجلالي by my might and glory لا أجمع على عبدي خوفين ولا أمنين. I will not make my servant experience two fears and two securities. فمن خافني في الدنيا أمنته يوم القيامة. Whosoever fears me in this world, I will grant him security in the day of resurrection. وَمَنْ أَمِنَنِي فِي الدُّنْيَا. And whoever walks around secure from the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will make him experience anxiety and fear in the day of resurrection. The condition of the people is different. الكافر, look how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described them. يخرجون من الأجداث سراعا كأنهم إلى نصب يوفضون. They will come out of the graves سراعا, marching, running. They will be driven. خاشعة أبصارهم ترهقهم ذلة. They will be lowering their gaze and humiliation will be covering all of them. ذلك اليوم الذي كانوا يوعدون. فالكافر will be humiliated, will come out humiliated from earth. We have the sinners, different people. Imagine, subhanallah, I always look and admire this. يحشر المتكبرون يوم القيامة كأمثال الذر في صور الرجال. Those who used to be arrogant in this world will rise from beneath the ground. Guess how little they will be. الذر is the صغار النمل, the small ants. Imagine the ant, he's not even an ant. But الذر, what is الذر? صغار النمل, little ants. في صور الرجال, they look like a human, so they will shrink. What people will do to them? Imagine the land of gathering. There are people, and we happened to share this with you last night after Isha, Allah will not look at. Allah is so angry with them. And we mentioned 10 to 14 types of those. We mentioned the one who is Mannan, the one who remind people of the favors he did for them, يعني I give you a sadaqa and say I giving you this and that and المسبل إزارة, someone who has his clothes beneath his ankle. وذكرنا المنفق سلعته بالحلف الكاذب, that by Allah this is $100 and it's only $1 or $2. But you're using oath in order what? You're using the name of Allah in order what? To make money. وذكرنا عائل المستكبر, someone who is poor but arrogant. وشيخ زان, an old man who commit adultery. See that? وملك كذاب, and a king who lies. These are just example of people who will be Allah will be angry with in the land of God. He's not going. We're talking about Muslims here. Muslims, people who said لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله, but they possess these qualities. مانع الزكاة, imagine this, مانع الزكاة, the one who refused to pay his زكاة المال, what will happen to him? His wealth will be transformed into a huge snake. A snake, huge snake. له ذبيبتان, has two horns. Guess he will chase that person in the land of gathering. He will tell to أنا كنزك, أنا مالك, wait, I'm your wealth, I'm your money. Imagine this. Someone who refused to pay what? Zakat. So different conditions. The kafir will be experiencing different conditions. The believer will be experiencing different conditions. The sinners of the Muslims will be experiencing different conditions. Different, يعني ورد في الأحاديث that the duration of standing until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comes to judge, we have three ahadith. One of them that said half a day, half a day of that day, that means how many years? Half a day of the 50,000 is what? 2,500? 25,000 years just standing. Warad. But look, Rasul was asked, for the believers, it will feel like the time to pray two rak'ahs. The 25,000 years. Or the 300. We said there are three hadith. 350. 25,000, 350. But for the believer, it will feel like, in one wording, as if he's praying two rak'ahs. Another wording, from the time when the sun goes down to set until it sets. You know, at a certain stage of the day, the sun starts what? Coming down. So from that time until the sun sets, this is how long this time will feel on a believer. But for the kafir, for the sinner, the 300. Add to this, تَدْنُ الشَّمْسُ مِنْ رُؤُوسِ الْخَلَائِقِ مِقْدَارَ مَيْلٍ. The sun, and by the way, the sun in the hereafter is 10 times, and I'm taking all of this from authentic ahadith. I don't mumble. I'm not making up that stuff. The sun in the hereafter is 10 times the sun of this world once it comes to heat. And it doesn't give light. It doesn't give light. ولذلك one of the beautiful things that will benefit you in the day of resurrection is what? Is what? Is what? What is this? من شاب شيبة في الإسلام. You see, if your hair turns gray while you're a Muslim, each hair will be light for you in the day of resurrection. Will give you light. So don't pull it out. Keep it. What else? What else will be, because I said the sun in the day of resurrection is a sun that which will give what? Heat. But no light. What else can benefit you? The salah that you just prayed. بشر المشائين إلى المساجد في الظلم بالنور التام يوم القيامة. Give glad tidings to those who walk or drive to the masajid at night, at the two darknesses. What are the two salahs where there are darknesses? Fajr and that they will have a complete light in the day of resurrection. So you need light. But the sun will give only heat to the extent that it will make people sweat. And people will be drowning in their sweat. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says, تدنو الشمس من رؤوس الخلائق مقدار ميل. So the distance between the people and the sun is 1 mile. Some of the scholars, they say, I think his name is Amir ibn Salim, one of the predecessors, we don't know what is meant by mail. Is it the distance, or it is the thing that the woman places in the mikhala? I think they call it mascara or something like that. They do like this with their, you know, they hold something, the sisters. You know that stuff, come on. Huh? Right. Imagine. So people will be soaking in their sweat, and each one will be based on his deeds. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa actually method. Some of them, the sweat will reach their nose. He will be doing like this. يغرق. He will be drowning. Add to this by all the sudden, وَجِيءَ يَوْمَئِذٍ بِجَهَنَّمٍ. See, the situation is getting what? The hellfire will be brought to the land of gathering. The hellfire. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم حديث عبد الله بن مسعود يؤتى بجهنم لها 70,000 زمام مع كل زمام 70,000 ملك يجرونها. Imagine, can somebody make the math? So 70,000 ropes, with each rope there are 70,000 angels. So what is the math? 49 something. I know this for a fact. But 49 what? 49 billion or 49 what? This is the number of angels who are trying to hold the hellfire down. Why the hellfire is held, needs to be held down? Why? Why? يَوْمَ نَقُولُ لِجَهَنَّمْ هَلْ امْتَلَأْتِ وَتَقُلْ. The hellfire is angry. The hellfire is upset. Why the hellfire is angry? Because of Allah's anger. يقول لك إذا رأتهم, the hellfire, إذا رأتهم من مكان بعيد سمعوا لها تغيظ وزفيرا. تغيظا وزفيرا, غيظ like this, تمور. You know, like a, you know when you find a lion is wants to attack somebody, the hellfire angry. شوف, it will be brought to the land of gathering. يومئذ يتذكر الإنسان وأن له الذكرى يقول يا ليتني قدمت لحياتي. I wish I have prepared for this. وذلك يقول لك ولو ترى إذ وقفوا على النار. If you would just see the disbeliever standing in front of hell, what will they say? وقالوا يا ليتنا نرد. شوف, what they are wishing for, they want to go where? Back to the dunya. وَلَا نُكَذِّبْ, and we promise we're not going to be lie. بِآيَاتِ اللَّهِ وَنَكُونَ مِنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ, and we'll believe. Yeah. But it's too late. ولذلك يا إخوة, one of the names of the day of resurrection is يَوْمُ الْحَسْرَةِ. One of the names of the day of resurrection is the day. Normally, the word hasra, right now you can translate it by saying regret. Regret. Why? Because when you regret something, you're still alive, you can what? You can fix it. But when we refer to the hereafter, we say what? Vain regret. Why vain regret? Why? Because regret is not going to help you. Whether you regret or not, it's over. It's useless. He will say, I wish I have done thing for this. So this is the conditions of the people, miserable, miserable condition. Of course, the believers will be what? All of this will be a piece of cake. Even so, they will be afraid. They will be anxiety and fear. They will still experience at least a portion of what's going on, but not as hard as the sinners of the Muslims or the disbelievers to begin with. At this stage, mankind will start directing their attentions to the messengers and the prophets. They will say to one another, listen, we used to have those people who come to us in this world and they spoke to us about this. They mean the messengers. We used to have these. We never believed them really. So let's try to ask them to help us. So they will immediately go to Adam alayhi salam. They will go to Adam. This is the ikhwa hadith, is a famous hadith in Sunnah called Hadith al-Shafa'ah, the hadith of intercession. O Adam, anta abu al-bashar, you are our father. Khalaqaka Allahu biyadayh, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created you with his own hands. With his sahih, Allah created Adam with his own hands. ونفخ فيك من روحي, and he has blown the soul in you. وأسجد لك ملائكته, and he commanded the angels to prostrate to you. وأسكنك جنته, in some of the wording, اشفع لنا, go and intercede for us. Why they are requesting intercession here? Why? For what? To go to Jannah? لا. Just to relieve them from standing. Just to take a break from the standing. They are tired. You know, it's like we're tired of this. Let's get out of this. Imagine you wish to go to die instead of experiencing that awful standing. They will find Adam alayhi salam saying, nafsi, 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 nafsi. Myself, myself, myself. Look, inna Allah. Look what they say. Remember, I said the hellfire is so angry. Inna Allah, indeed Allah, قد غضب غضبا لم يغضب مثله قبله ولن يغضب مثله بعده. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is so angry today that he has never been angry like this before, and he will never be angry like this afterwards. Shuf, subhanallah, in spite of the fact, and this is something that you really need to reflect upon, that Allah has forgiven his sin. We know, binas al-Quran, فَتَلَقَّى آدَمُ مِنْ رَبِّهِ كَلِمَاتٍ فَتَابَ عَلَيْهِ. Adam received words from Allah in order to repent, and Allah accepted his repentance. Yet Adam in the day of resurrection will say, I ate from the tree which I was banned to eat from. So he's actually going to recall what? He's going to recall the sins. Subhanallah. He's going to recall the sin. Something that... So that's the anxiety. This is what the fear and the anxiety will do to you. That he's actually going to recall things that Allah actually forgiven you and pardoned you. Go to Nuh. Mankind will go to Nuh alayhi salam. Ya Nuh, they will mention you're the first messenger sent to mankind. And it's true, Nuh is the first messenger. Adam is Nabi. Yani قول الجمهور, he's a prophet. And we know the difference between a messenger and a prophet, that the messenger brings a new sharia, a new revelation to the people. Ya Nuh, anta awwal ar-rusul, you're the first of the messengers. Ishfa' lana. Nuh will mention there are two words, two things. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned in an authentic hadith that every messenger was given a supplication that is to be accepted. دعوة مستجابة. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم لكل نبي دعوة مستجابة. Every messenger will have an answered supplication. Now every messenger used his supplication. But I spared mine to turn into what? شفاعة. That الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم will ask Allah in the day of resurrection in person. يا رب أمتي أمتي. He'll say my أمة my أمة. Will turn into شفاعة. That he's gonna ask Allah regarding us. فآدم used his دعوة. How did he use it? When he made دعاء against his people. عفوا نوح used his supplication. When he made دعاء against his people, what did he say? وقال نوح ربي لا تذر على الأرض من الكافرين ديارا. سبحان الله. يعني لما نبي يدعو على قوم. Oh Allah, make all the disbelievers vanish from earth. Why? Look at this. إنك إن تذرهم يضل عبادك. If you leave the disbelievers, they are misguiding the people. And there is no hope in their progeny, in their offspring. ولا يلدوا إلا فاجرا كفارا. Their kids are what? Born what? In a state of fujur, in a state of disbelief. Wickedness and disbelief. This is one of the wording. Another wording that he asked Allah a question he should not have asked Allah. With respect to his son. We know that when Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam was building the ark, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised him to save his family. فأوحينا إليه أن اصنع الفلك بأعيننا ووحينا واحمل فيها من كل زوجين اثنين وأهلك and your family. Now when the ship was sailing وهي تجري بهم في موج كالجبال, Nuh realized that one of his sons is not on the ship with him. ونادى نوح ابنه وكان في معزل يا بني my son اركب معنا come with us ولا تكن مع الكافرين and don't be amongst the disbelievers. What his son said to him. قال يا أبتي, he said, my father, سآوي إلى جبل يعصمني من الماء. I will go to the top of this mountain will protect me from the water. قال لا عاصم اليوم من أمر الله إلا من رحم. There is no protection but on the ship. Basically, his son is a disbeliever. So his son drowned, died. So no, when Nuh parked the ship or the ship stopped, ونادى نوح ربه, Nuh called upon Allah. فقال ربي, he said, my Lord, this is the questioning that he made. إن ابني من أهلي. My son is one from my family. وإن وعدك الحق. And you promised me to save my family. But look, you know, he felt like he overdid it. Look at Nabi. Huh? Then he said, وَأَنْتَ أَحْكَمُ الْحَاكِمِينَ. But there must be a wisdom. He backed off a little bit. You know, but there must be a wisdom behind this. Because Allah said that I'm going to save your family. Huh? Now his son drowned. When the ship stopped, قال رب إن ابني من أهلي. Oh Allah, my son is from my family. And you promised to save my family. وَإِنَّ وَعْدَكَ الْحَقِّ. But there must be a wisdom. Because أَنْتَ أَحْكَمْ الْحَاكِمِ. Look how Allah responded to him. قال يا نوح إنه ليس من أهلك. يا نوح, he is not from your from your family. شوف, he is his son. إنه عمل غير صالح. He is unrighteous deed. Just to show you, know that the relationship between the people, the top of the line is what? Is faith. Then comes what? Blood. Comes blood. يعني we read the story of what's his name, the one who was sent to Medina to teach the people Quran. Huh? Mus'ab. He used to have a brother, and he used to, I'm your brother. He said, no, he is my brother more than you. He was, that's not my brother. In the Battle of Badr. He's my brother. You're not my brother. Then the relation, this is how the companions took that deal. You know? ذلك أبو بكر الصديق رضي الله عنه, he had a son whose name is عبد الرحمن. عبد الرحمن or عبد الله؟ عبد الرحمن, who did not accept Islam. So he was fighting with the disbelievers, the مشركين مكة, on the day of Badr. So later on he accepted Islam. So he was telling his father what happened. فقال يا أبتي, he said, my father, لقد ترأيت إلي يوم بدر. I spotted you in the day of Badr, but in the battle. يعني look. So I spotted you in the battlefield, but I went away in order not to fight you. So what Abu Bakr did to him? والله إن رأيتك لقتلتك. If I see you, I would have killed you. علاقة دين. ولذلك يقول لك لا تجد قوما يؤمنون بالله واليوم الآخر يوادون من حاد الله ورسوله ولو كانوا آباءهم أو أبناءهم. الكفار على فكرة non Muslims, they don't understand this. They tell you, يا أخي, your Quran tells you that you're not supposed to love us. You're not some, يا أخي, I can't love you. I have no control over my heart. I can. You see, if your heart loves somebody who disbelieves in Allah, then there is something wrong with your heart. There is something wrong with the heart. I can't. You see, the love and hate is the act of the heart. الشاهد, we don't want to prolong this. يا نوح, he is not your son. في قراءة تقول لك إنه عمل غير صالح. يعني هو كافر يعني. فلا تسألني ما ليس لك به. So Nuh is gonna remember this. I asked Allah a question I should not have asked him. Guru Ibrahim. Imagine Ibrahim, the friend of Allah. Mankind will find him saying نفسي 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 myself myself. يا إبراهيم, أو إبراهيم, أنت خليل الله. You're the friend of Allah. اشفع لنا. Help us. Please. Just go and intercede before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to begin judgment. Ibrahim alayhi salam will recall the three, we call them white lies. We call them ma'arid. يعني the word ma'arid. والمعاريض يا إخوة is something that sometimes you have to use because you don't want to lie. وعمر بن الخطاب tells you عجبت لمن يكذب وعلم المعاريض. What is المعاريض? That you say something, you say something, you know the listener will understand it in a certain way, but you mean something else in your heart. But provided that you're not going to wrong somebody with this. But if you take an oath, or if the person, the listener requests you to take an oath, خلاص, you have to say it. You can't take an oath in ma'arid, in white lies. Like I tell you, there is a drink here. You're asking me it's a coffee. Oh, it's a drink. Huh. You know, drink can mean what? But you're asking whether it is coffee or not. والله. If I say والله, then it has to be a drink. What you meant. So if you take an oath, you cannot use ma'arid and you take an oath. You can't. Just to show you how they did it. During the time of Imam Ahmad, there was some scholar whose name is Al-Marwazi. Al-Marwazi borrowed some money from somebody. And the time to pay back is here and he doesn't have any money. So the person came to collect his debt. Al-Marwazi is running away from him. So he came to the house of Imam Ahmad. The man was really behind Al-Marwazi to harm him, as if he's going to beat him up if he doesn't pay him back the money. So he said to Imam Ahmad, please help me, let me go inside. He said, go inside. The man saw him entering into the house of Imam Ahmad. So he's telling him, Al-Marwazi huna? Is Al-Marwazi here? Look at Imam Ahmad. Al-Marwazi huna? هنا هنا no what هنا not in the house هنا هذا هو المعريض تعرض بالكلام you have to do that I'm sorry I mean قال صلى الله عليه وسلم the prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says ثلاثة من الكذب لا أعدهن كذبا your wife cooks for you dinner And she puts it on the table in front of you. And you cannot even bear it in front of you. Oh, what do you think about my cooking? What are you going to say? What are you going to say? Man, one of a kind. The best. Never had anything like that before in my life. So delicious. But you know, I'm a little bit full tonight. I will have it for breakfast. And in the middle of the night, wake up. I think we have sisters here. We're discipline ourselves here. So in the middle of the night, you collect it and throw it in the trash or something. But you have ma'arid. Yeah, it's good. You telling your wife she's beautiful. She may not be beautiful. I mean, according to you. But, oh, you're beautiful. Or... You're trying to make up between two brothers. You know that two brothers are having issues. Oh, mashallah, wallahi, he praises you. He could be somebody else. But he's trying what? كَذِبُ الرَّجُلِ يُصْلِحَ بَيْنَ الرَّجُلَيْنِ أو كَذِبُ الرَّجُلِ فِي الْحَرْبِ You know, like the story of the people of the trench, when this little boy was beaten up by the sorcerer and by his family, what did the scholar tell him? If the sorcerer asks you why you're late, tell him my family got me late, and your family tells him that the sorcerer got me late. معارض كذب الرجل في الحرب. This is lying during the time of war. فإبراهيم did like this. They wanted him to come and worship the idols with them. فنظر نظرة في النجوم. He looked up and he said, إني سقيم. I'm sick of your idols. But when you say you're sick, that means you're what? What is the person is going to think that when you say you're sick? That you're physically sick. You can't go out because he, Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam wanted to wait until they go out. So he goes and he executes his plan with the idols. So he said, "Ana inni saqim." He said, I'm sick. But he looked up and I'm sick of the stars that you're going to worship. فَنَظَرَ نظرة في النجوم فقال إني سقيم. When he said I'm sick, what did they understand that he's physically what? So this is what Ibrahim عليه السلام is recalling in the day of resurrection. إني كذبت ثلاث كذبات. The second one said the big one did it. Now why is he saying that for them to reflect? The big one did it. And the third one, when they took away Sarah from him, and he said, tell them that you're my sister. He meant you're my sister in Islam. Ma'arid. But yet these three will make him fear on that day. شوف احنا عمالين ننشع في كذب صبح وليل. الله المستعان. ما فيش ma'arid اصلا. شغالين كذب اصلي. Original lying.
ها والله المستعان في يوم القيامة. ربنا يستر علينا يا رب. نسأل الله أن يسترنا يا رب العالمين. مشكلة مشكلة الكذب. قولوا موسى what Musa will recall the Egyptians he hit by accident and he killed him. يا إخوة it was accidental killing, it was not intentional killing. سيدنا موسى عليه السلام was known of his body, so he grabbed the Egyptians, يعني coincided with his قدر. قال إني قتلت نفسا لم أؤمر بقتلها. I killed a soul I was not commanded to kill. نفسي نفسي. Allah is so angry today. Guru Isa عليه الصلاة والسلام. Something so fascinating إخوة, that Prophet Isa عليه السلام will not mention a sin. Will not mention a sin. But yet in spite of this he will be saying نفسي نفسي. Allah is so angry today. He has been never angry like this before, and he will never be angry like this afterwards. Go to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Here is the beauty. Wallahi ya ikhwa, ya'ani rasul yuhibbuna, a messenger who loves us. Mankind will find Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying ummati 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 ummati. Imagine every human being will be preoccupied or occupied with his own nafs, and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will be occupied with us, concerned. And the people will say to him ishfa' lana ya Rasulullah, you're the last messenger, go and intercede for us. He will say sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ana laha, ana laha, I am for it, I am for it. Then he says fa'adhhabu, then I will go, he will leave this crowd, he will go to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, fa'akhiru tahta al-arsh sajida, I will go down prostrating underneath the throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ثم يفتح الله علي بمحامد لم يفتح بها على أحد قبلي. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reveal to me names and attributes of his, and we use this as an evidence, by the way, when we want to establish the fact that the names of Allah are infinite. That here is Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the day of resurrection is praising Allah using names and attributes that never been used by what? A human. Because it's never been revealed. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say, Ya Muhammad, O Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, irfa' ra'sak, raise your head, wasal tu'ta, ask you will be given. وَشْفَعْ تُشَفَّعْ and intercede and your intercession will be accepted. And this is يَا إِخْوَى الْمَقَامُ الْمَحْمُودِ. We always recite this verse. وَمِنَ اللَّيْلِ فَتَهَجَّدْ بِهِ نَافِلَةً لَكَ عَسَى أَنْ يَبْعَثَكَ رَبُّكَ مَقَامًا مَحْمُودًا. And at night pray tahajjud so that Allah will give you that status. Because this is the best status that a humankind can reach. Imagine all of humanity are stuck and you're chosen to go intercede before Allah. Not only this, your intercession is accepted. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, by the way, when this hadith was recited, أَنَا سَيِّدُ وَلَدِ آدَمَ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ, I'm the leader of the children of Adam in the day of resurrection. Yeah. But yet he had to work for it. And we can actually contribute to this by doing what? What can we do after each adhan? What do we do? Huh? We make dua for him. What do we do? Allahumma rabbana rabb hadhihi ad-da'wati at-tamma was-salati al-qa'imah ati Muhammadan al-wasilah wal-fadilah. شوف ما هذا, وابعثه اللهم مقاما محمودا الذي وعدت. You're actually making dua for Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم for this to happen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will command the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to go back to the land of gathering. And then the next scene is Maji'ur Rabb, the coming of Allah. Like I said, يا إخوة نحن نثبت الاستواء على العرش والمجيء. These attributes of Allah, we affirm it, we believe in it. But again, we believe in it in a way that suits Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, suits His names and attributes. So with this, inshallah, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam interceded for all of humanity for Allah to begin judgment. We call this al-shafa'atul uzma, the great shafa'ah. The great shafa'ah. The shafa'ah for what? The Muslim and the non-Muslims. Ala sawa. For Allah to come in a way that suits His Majesty to begin reckoning. ليبدأ الحساب. But there is another shafa'ah the Prophet will perform. For who? For عصات المسلمين. The sinners of the Muslims. He will make shafa'ah for certain people to enter Jannah. He will make shafa'ah for those whose good and bad ended up to be لهم أهل الأعراف. أصحابه على الأعراف يا رجال شفاعة النبي تدخلهم النار أصحاب الكبائر. He will make شفاعة that Allah will elevate your rank in Jannah. وذاك الفوز بشفاعة النبي ده هذا حلت له. That's why whoever makes this دعاء حلت له شفاعة يوم القيامة. We take these things for life. For الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم will can intercede for your rank in Jannah to be elevated from 50 to 100 for example. وسبحان الله في شفاعة للكفار. He will intercede for his uncle. Who's? Which one? Abu Talib. So that he will receive the lowest punishment in hell. ففي levels of شفاعة. في شفاعة that he will take out every Muslim who said لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله and he did not do good but the weight of an atom. Imagine. فهذه شفاعة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. But the one that we hinted at, inshallah we're going to cover the subject of الشفاعة further when we go through the scenes, maybe on Sunday inshallah. But you now reached the scene of the coming of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Mankind are standing in the land of gathering. They requested the intercession of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam after passing by Ulul Azm, Adam wa Nuh wa Ibrahim wa Musa wa Isa. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the one who will be entitled to intercede. He went to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He interceded for Allah to come and judge. Inshallah, 2 o'clock tomorrow, بإذن الله تعالى, we're going to begin with that scene, the coming of Allah, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to come, descend from one earth to heaven to another, and the way, هَلْ يَنْظُرُونَ إِلَّا أَنْ يَأْتِيَهُمُ اللَّهُ فِي ظُلَلٍ مِنَ الْغَمَامِ وَالْمَلَائِكَةِ وَقُضِيَ الْأَمْرُ وَإِلَى اللَّهِ تُرْجَعُ الْأُمُورُ. ويوم تشقق السماء بالغمام ونزل الملائكة تنزيلا الملك يومئذ الحق للرحمن. So inshallah beginning tomorrow inshallah we're going to go over the coming of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then we're going to focus on the scene of الحساب, reckoning, how the حساب is going to start بإذن الله تعالى. Alright, so we covered so far 3 scenes: the scene of the destruction of the living, the scene of resurrection, the scene of the standing, actually 4, and the scene of the shafa'ah, the major shafa'ah or the great shafa'ah. Tomorrow, inshallah, we're going to begin with the coming of Allah to the land of gathering, to the land where people are standing, and then address the scene of the hisab, the reckoning, the accountability. جزاكم الله خيرا سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك والحمد لله رب العالمين.